5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Learned Counsel, appearing on behalf of the appellant, submitted that having found that the findings of the scrutiny committee were correct, the High Court should not have quashed the order of termination of service, as admittedly the employee had obtained appointment by fraudulent means by producing a false caste certificate. It was asserted that neither the delay in reference to the scrutiny committee nor the time taken by the committee in scrutinizing the certificate can be used as a ground to validate a fraudulent action. It was also urged that having entered into the service by deceitful means, rendering of long period of services does not entitle the appellant to any relief in equity. Per contra, learned senior counsel, appearing on behalf of the employee while supporting the decision of the High Court, submitted that in the absence of any finding by the scrutiny committee that the caste certificate had been obtained fraudulently, the High Court was justified in directing her reinstatement. He further contended that it has not been evolved as a general principle that in every case where the caste claim is rejected, the equitable jurisdiction of the court is ousted. In support of the submission that the parameters for consideration of claim for employment are different in a case of fraud as compared to a mere rejection of such a claim, learned counsel referred us to the decisions of this court in Punjab National Bank Supra. In the above background, the questions for our consideration would be whether delay in making references to the scrutiny committee for verification of the caste certificate, as also the delay on the part of the scrutiny committee in such verification, per se vitiates the order of termination of services of an employee, even when the certificate is ultimately found to be false, and whether because of the employee having rendered services to the employer for over 20 years, would it be equitable to cancel her appointment when admittedly in the first instance the employee was not eligible for such appointment. It was said that the admission wrongly gained, the appointment wrongly obtained on the basis of false social status certificate necessarily has the effect of depriving the genuine scheduled castes or scheduled tribes or OBC candidates as enjoyed in the constitution of the benefits conferred on them by the constitution. The genuine candidates are also denied admission to educational institutions or appointments to office or posts under a state for want of social status certificate. Therefore, with a view to streamline the procedure for the issuance of social status certificates, their scrutiny and their approval, the court issued as many as 15 directions. One of the directions so issued was that as soon as the finding is recorded by the scrutiny committee holding that the certificate obtained was false, on its cancellation or confiscation simultaneously, it should be communicated to the educational institutions concerned or the appointing authority with a request to cancel the admission or the appointment.